to shake it up every time you want to use it. It is not a heavy cream. It is a lightweight, like a runny liquid. And I've been using this for months, like a year. I don't get that much sunshine where I live, but whenever I go outside and there's sun, I apply this, so I use it constantly, and it lasts me a very good amount of time. I have never been burned using it, like, it works. I would definitely recommend this. You do get oily, like, I don't think any sun protection product can claim that they're not gonna make you super, super oily, but it is less than what I've experienced using another sun cream, which was from the Beauty of Joseon brand. That did make me more oily than this one, and I like this one way more. But yeah, it's worth the money for me. I will buy this again. And I also really like the Lancaster sun lotion cream. I only tried the trial size of it because they don't really sell it in the stores where I live, so I need to order it online, but I think that's the next one that I'm gonna get. Both of them have like orange packaging. Another thing, I feel like that goes quite unnoticed, or like you don't really realize that you might need it, especially on very sunny days, or strangely when you go skiing because you're so close to the sun. I've never been skiing, but my boyfriend has been skiing with his like work friends and, like, on a company trip, and he brought back this Ultra Sun SPF 30 chapstick, and it's really good, and I have been using it like just for chapstick reasons. Honestly, I don't really use chapstick. It smells like very faintly of blackcurrant because it has blackcurrant seed oil. It's very hydrating. I love this thing. Like, on its own as a chapstick, it's really good because it's got that oil, and it's not just the paraffin, although it does have paraffin, like third ingredient, but it does have SPF 30, and this company Ultra Sun is a really good brand for sun creams. If you have like dry skin, I feel like their creams would suit you better. But yeah, like a little chapstick with SPF in it is definitely a very good idea, especially if you live in a warm climate. Definitely needs to be in your bag. Okay, my favorite product category is lip glosses. I love lip glosses. I've talked about it many times. If you've been here, I've recommended one specific product countless times. Maybe not recently, but this NYX butter gloss, and I'm not gatekeeping, obviously I'm sharing this with you. This NYX butter gloss in this specific shade, spiked toffee. I don't know if it will zoom in, but spiked toffee. This shade is incredible. I will say that these glosses, I feel like, absorb into my skin, and they kind of like disappear quite fast. They are very cheap, so that is understandable, but they are very lightweight. but she knows what she's doing, you know? And it lasts for a very, very long time. Like, you don't have to keep buying once, once, you know, you tried them all in the stores, watched them and applied them and whatnot. And once you found your shade, you don't have to keep buying new ones. I literally have those three and I don't buy anymore. I keep going back to the ones that I know I love. And another one that I've been raving about countless times is this Ilia Balmy Gloss. So this is a balmy gloss, a tinted lip oil. And let me come and show you up close what this looks like. It's got this frosted tube here. Very classy. Love, love, love Ilia products. I would like to try their foundation. I've never used foundation in my entire life, but Ilia makes me want to buy their foundation because it looks like something I would wear, like a very lightweight kind of skincare kind of based foundation. And their products are very aesthetically pleasing, I would say, and the quality is really good. I have a lipstick from them that is kind of like a balm, but I would say if you want to try something from them and something that is like less risky, like if you don't like it, you know, that's it, I would say go for like the Balmy Gloss, because this is the best thing I've ever tried. Like, when I tried this for the first time, I was like, oh my god, why haven't I like found out about them before? They actually recently started selling their products in the UK, I believe, and I first found them in America, and gosh, I love this color. It's called Tahiti. So yeah, it's a wonderful color. It's got this doe foot applicator that is kind of curved. I don't really use that bit. I feel like it applies so much product. I am very like, I'm kind of like a, okay, that's not kind of girl. I'm like going to make this product last as long as I can. But that one is also like, because it's an oil, it has no stickiness whatsoever. But the difference with this product is the color stays. The color will stay for a while, a very long time. Unless like you rub it off with a tissue or something. And I quite often will use this before going to bed as like a hydrating kind of treatment. I don't really mind about the color. It doesn't transfer on my like pillowcase or anything, because I sleep on my back and I wake up and my lips are freaking amazing. So I definitely love that. Yeah, it just glides literally so smoothly, and I feel like I've created this really nice berry kind of shade. I do love a berry shade. I'm not like a pink kind of girl, like somewhere in the middle, you know. Okay, so I have my last few things that you need to have in your bag. So some of them are random, not makeup related. So like kind of like the last makeup related thing would be an amazing mascara. I do my makeup on the way to work, so I always have these things in my bag. That's why my bags are always heavy. But if you are also a girly that does her makeup on her way to work, I would say like an amazing mascara is definitely what you should have. And this one, see, I have two. I love this product, but this one has like this ugly wrapper on it. This one is empty. This is the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. It is a classic. I think this had a little bit of controversy with it. separate your lashes with this, and you will get the longest separated looking lashes with this product, I think. So you have to use a different mascara brush, which is a mistake that I was making when I first started using this, and I was thinking, why would anyone use this? It's so clumpy. Like, am I doing something wrong? And I feel like this will not only, you will use less product, so you do like one swipe of the full product, and however many swipes it takes you with the mascara wand that doesn't have any product on it, and that will take, I feel like, make it last longer. This is kind of bougie. It is a Chanel mascara, and it gives you false lashes, okay? Like, this is freaking amazing. I keep this, again, this is empty.
Redness when
your nail might break, which will cause you more harm, like, if you don't file it down, than if you keep it, like that the whole day. Like, it might break more, like, who knows what can happen, but definitely get one of these things. They sell them in 3-packs, 6-packs, whatever. You don't need that many, like, 3 is enough. And then get one that you can use over and over again, like a nail file that is glass or metal. I have a metal one, and I don't replace that. That's like, I use that for the rest of my life. You don't need to replace it. And these things are perfect when you want to put them in your bag. Very lightweight, not sharp. And when you're traveling, do get these. I feel like this is very overlooked. But as a girly who likes to do my nails, and I did some new ones a day ago for like a summer kind of look. I have one of these in my bag at all times, and it's like original plastic container so that it doesn't like get the nail dust everywhere. And the last product that I have to show you is a deodorant, because some of y'all out there are nasty and you're going around smelling like BO. Some of y'all is me sometimes, but if you smell or if you are like, I don't know, some people have anxiety about smelling, and sometimes you don't, like, I'm a person who doesn't put on deodorant every single day because I don't like sweat a lot. Like, I go to the office and I just sit down and we have AC. Like, I don't really get these sweats or whatever. But sometimes, if, like, especially if girls, you're on your period, it's that time of the month, I feel much hotter and I sweat more and I stink more. So I definitely have a deodorant with me. I cannot control it. Something hormonal, and I think it happens with everyone, whether you're a man or a woman. You know, everybody stinks at some point. But yeah, definitely have a little roll-on. And what I would say is, do not get a spray deodorant at any time, ever, because they're not good for the planet. The spray of that pressurized container is destroying the ozone layer. I don't know if anybody went to, I don't know, middle school environmental class, but that's what I learned. They're not very great, and honestly, like, I don't know, I don't like the smell of them most of the time. This is my current favorite one. It's the pomegranate scent from Dove. I think they're a Unilever company, and I know Unilever is not good if you want to be sustainable, but I can't all fight all the battles, okay? This is what I used. I think they stopped making my favorite one, which is the apple scented one. Oh my god, it's so good. I was resigned to using the coconut scent, and honestly, that doesn't smell nearly as good as the apple scent. Neither does this. It's apple, pomegranate, coconut for me. I don't like the other.